Now I am going to discuss about food safety and standards, packaging and labeling regulations 2011. I have mentioned earlier that any act to implement, there should be some rules and regulations made under the act, derived from various sections of the act. The food safety and standards, packaging and labeling regulation is one of them. In fact, there are six regulations made under the Food Safety and Standard Acts. Apart from this regulation, other five are licensing and registration of food business regulations, food products standards and additive regulations, prohibitions of sale of certain food products, contaminants, toxin and residue regulations, and laboratory sampling and analysis regulations. Now, coming to the Food Safety and Standard Packaging and Labeling Act, why packaging and labeling is important? Packaging is essential to protect food from contamination and hazards during storage and distribution. I already mentioned that a product may be, food may be made unsafe from the packaging material itself. So, while using packaging material for prepackaged food, a packaging material should be food grade, it does not do any harm to the food, and this packaging material should have good barrier of gas, water, light, etc., and it passed through migration test. There may be migration of molecules of the substances from which a packaging material is made, and there may be color migration also. So, a packaging material should be conformed to the migration test. It is necessary to use therefore the right packaging material for foods prescribed under the regulations. In the regulations, the different packaging material, the standards are prescribed based on Bureau of Indian Standards. So, a packaging material should conform to these standards. A food business operator should buy the packaging material from the supplier with a testing certificate with it, and also food regulators should analyze the sample of packaging materials from time to time to ensure that packaging material is of food grade. General packaging requirement: all packaging materials should conform to Bureau of Indian Standards, already I mentioned. All containers should securely packed and sealed. The exterior of cans should be free from major dent, rust, perforations and distortions if the product is packed in cans. Then cans should be free from leaks. If this defect is there, then product may be contaminated with microorganisms and the product may be got spoiled. So, this should be taken into consideration. Then coming to specific requirement of packaging material. For milk and milk products, the milk and milk product is highly perishable. So, bottling and filling of heat treated milk to be done mechanically so that it is immediately sealed or packed, and sealing of containers done automatically, or if it is not done automatically, it is done manually, it should be done immediately without exposing to air. Wrapping and packing shall not be reused for packing of milk and milk products, so that contamination is not occur from packaging materials. For edible oils and fats, plate of tin containers for oils, because for oils mostly plastic or tin containers are used. If tin containers are used, this should meet the Bureau of Indian Standards 1993 or 13/1955 or 9025 or 13,955. These standards are prescribed in BIS. Tin and plastic containers once used cannot be reused for edible oils and fats, because this container, then there may be adhering of oils, and this will allow the foreign material like dust and other contaminants to the packaging material. So, the containers should not be reused for repacking of oils and fats. For foods and vegetable products, canned fruits and vegetable product, OTS means open top sanitary cans, with the cans having one side opens and then it is hermetically sealed. This type of can may be used for pickles, bottles, glass bottles or thermoplastic bottles or PET bottles or jars or wooden cask and tin containers. If it is used with 250 gauge polythene, a lining shall be used for inner lining. This product may not be used or packed directly to the tin containers. For tomato ketchup sauces or sauce product, acidic product, if acidity is less than 0.5%, then open top sanitary cans may be used. Otherwise, if it is more than 0.5%, then there may be internal corrosion and leakage of the cans, resulting to contamination and making food unsafe. For canned meat also, open top cans, sanitary cans with sulfur resistance, because meat is a protein product, meat or fish. So, there is a sulfur content in the product, and sulfur is highly corrosive. So, sulfur resistance cans with internal lacquer should be used. Then that is the specification for packing pork meat. That container should be internally coated with edible gelatin, lard or lined with vegetable parchment paper before filled. Meat products packed in hermetically sealed container, hermetically means this airtight container, shall withstand spoilage under commercial conditions of storage and transport, because in case of storage, if it is temperature high or transportation temperature high, there may be chances of microbial growth in favorable conditions. So, that this container should be suitably sealed. For packaged drinking water also, there is specification for bottles. This polyethylene bottle should be of BSI standards 10146. And PVC polyvinyl chloride bottles 10151, for PET bottle it is 12252, and polypropylene 10910 standards. Food grade polycarbonate or sterile glass bottles also may be used for packing of packaged drinking water. The packaged drinking water a bottle should be properly cleaned and should be transparent, so that the water can be seen from outside, whether there is any foreign matters in the bottles or not can be observed by a consumer. So, these are the requirements for particular packing materials. Now, coming to the labeling. Labeling is very important for a consumer point of view. One can buy a product seeing all the declarations, and he has got informed choice. So, definition on labeling is a broad sense. It may be a tag, a brand, pictorial or other descriptive matter. It may be written or printed. It may be stenciled, marked, embossed, graphic or perforated, stamped or impressed on or attached to container. It may be cover, lid. It may be put in the surface of the container or on the cover or lid or crown of the bottles, where crown cap is used. I already mentioned labeling, the necessity of labeling and importance of labeling. It also gives an information of a person in supply chain, whether the product is perishable or highly perishable, or how to handle the product during transport and storage, and of course for consumer for informed choice. There are certain requirements for packing on declaration on the container. A declaration should either be made on English language or Hindi. However, other languages, national, regional languages or international languages may be allowed in addition to either of the two. Label to be applied in a manner so that it is not separated from the container, it is properly fixed. Whenever the container is covered by a wrapper, it shall carry necessary information on the label or on the container itself so that it can be readily legible through the wrapper, because wrapper is transparent. But if wrapper is not transparent, then the declaration should be made on the wrapper itself. The contents on the label shall be clear, prominent, not ambiguous, and readily legible under normal condition. It should not be read through a lens. Description or presentation of food not to be done in a manner that is false or misleading regarding its quality, characters, or any other aspect of the origin of the food. Violation of any of the provision of labeling requirement attract penalty. For example, if it is a misbranding product, misbranding means if any of the requirement of labeling declaration is not made as per the manner of declaration, or any of the declaration is missing in the on the label, then penalty up to 5 lakhs under misbranding clause. And if there is a misleading statement regarding its quality, regarding the health benefit, or misleading advertisement, there may be penalty up to 10 lakhs of rupees. Then what are the declarations to be made on the label? There are actually 12 declarations under FSSAI packaging and labeling regulations. First one is name of the food. It may be generic name or common name or description of food contained in the package. List of ingredients. Ingredients to be declared in descending order. That means whichever is more quantity in the package or on the product, this should be given first, and similarly in the descending order in volume or weight. And if water is used in the product in case of beverages or sarbat or other sweetened juices or ready to serve beverage, the quantity of water also, amount of water also to be declared as an ingredient. The declaration of ingredients is exempted in case the product is made from a single ingredients. But if additive is there, this should be declared on the label. Additives means color, flavor, or preservatives, which are added for preservation or other technological purposes. So, the name of the additives, whether it is single additive, this should be declared. Nutritional information to be declared in gram or ml or per serving. The following nutritional information are mandatory. That is energy value in kilocalorie, amount of protein, carbohydrate, also quantity of sugar, that is sucrose content in the carbohydrate, also to be declared, and in fat in gram. Further, recent amendment by the FSSAI, the declaration of amount of trans fat and saturated fat is also made mandatory on the label under nutritional information. Amount of other nutrient like vitamins and minerals for which a claim is made, or if health claim is made, this should be declared on the label. Quantity of nutrients in food enriched with these nutrients should be declared. Then vegetarian or non-vegetarian logo. If vegetarian logo, this is indicated by a green color logo. If it is a non-vegetarian food, it is a brown color logo. Logo shall bear to the name of the product. It is to be near to the product, not anywhere. And size of the logo should be as per prescribed diameter of the circle in the logo. For example, for 200 gram, the diameter should be minimum 1 millimeter, or 200 to 500 gram, it is 2 millimeter, 500 to 1 kg, it is 4 millimeter, and above 1 kg, it is 6 millimeter is prescribed. So, this size of the logo, the circle, diameter of the circle actually, this size to be maintained. Then declaration of additives like color and flavor to be declared, And regarding color and flavor, class name of permitted additives, whether it is a synthetic color or it is a natural color or a synthetic flavor or natural flavor, this should be declared. With INS number, international numeric system is there, this number also to be mentioned is in the side of the particular color. Declaration of color and flavor should be given in bold letter, like contains permitted natural color or contains permitted synthetic food colors or contains permitted natural or synthetic food color, that may be combined. And if flavor is added, then three declaration may be combined, like this contains permitted natural or synthetic food colors, and added right name of the flavor, say pineapple flavor or mango flavor or rose flavor, then added rose flavor. So this type of declaration should be made in bold letter, and with particular size of the letter I have already mentioned in packaging and labeling in a declaration in legal metrology rules also, and it is also prescribed in FSSAI packaging and labeling regulations. Name and address of the manufacturer, then the complete address of the manufacturer or manufacturing unit located in different places. If a manufacturer having a head office in a particular place, then having a common license, so he have to write this license number of, and if he is a brand owner, he has to write his office address. In addition to that, address of the manufacturing unit to be given. And in case of imported food, name and address of the manufacturer and importer and country of origin to be declared on the label. Net quantity by weight or volume. In addition to that, if a product is packed in liquid medium like canned fruits or vegetable, the drain weight of content to be declared. Weight of wrapper or packaging material is excluded, but in case of Legal Metrology Act it is not excluded, but however in FSSAI rules it is excluded, except in certain cases like confectionery. If a small pack is packed in a big packages and wholesale packages, the total weight does not exceed 8% in case of wax paper, and in case of other paper it does not exceed 6%, then weight of paper may be excluded from the total net weight declaration, net quantity declaration. Then lot number or batch number or code number for identification of product, and also date of manufacture. In case of bread, however, bread and milk and other product which shelf life is less than 7 days, this lot number or date of manufacture is not required. In case of shelf life is less than 3 months, date, month and year of manufacture to be declared on the label. But if it is more than 3 months shelf life, then only month and year declaration is sufficient. Then best before or is by date is to be declared. This should be declared in bold letter like this, best before months. Suppose it is 12 months, they have to declare best before 12 months from date of manufacture, or he can declare best before by December if it is more than 3 months, by December 2016, or if it is terms of months, maybe best before 12 months or 18 months from date of packing or manufacture. In case of infant foods or some other foods, it is use by date or expiry date or recommended last date of use to be declared. And in case of product having less than 7 days shelf life, use by date to be declared, like bread or milk, liquid milk, use by date to be declared instead of best before date. Other declaration like instruction for use, how it is to be used, the serving suggestions, how it to be consumed. In case of frozen product, how it is to be thawed, how it is to be kept in freeze it should be kept in low temperature. This type of instruction should be given. Then there are some specific statement for product like irradiated foods, iodized salt, iron fortified salt, food with sodium and potassium salt, infant foods, blended oils and food containing monosodium glutamate, artificial sweeteners or caffeine, etc. Some specific declaration should be given, like the salt is fortified with iodine or sodium or potassium, or in case of blended oils, name of the oils, tube oils to be given specifically. And food containing monosodium glutamate declaration, like the food contains monosodium glutamate, not suitable for infants or children below 12 years, like this. Or in case of artificial sweeteners or product containing caffeine also, this declaration should be given, that product contains artificial sweetener like sucralose or saccharin, or it contains caffeine, not suitable for infants or children below 3 years, like this. Then FSSAI license number with logo in the manner it is displayed in the slides, it is mandatory. Then coming to the manner of declaration also is there. Declaration shall be legible and prominent with prescribed size of letters and numerals already mentioned. No false or misleading statements concerning package, quality, quantity, nutritive value or its place of origin to be given. Like the product is manufactured somewhere, it is Kashmiri saffron or Kashmiri apple, if it is grown somewhere else, like that. All information grouped together and given in principal display panel only. Area of principal display panel and height of letters and numerals shall be as per prescribed area and height. One should remember this should be there, otherwise it will be a contravention of the requirement. Then area of display panel in case of package of rectangular size, 40% of product height and weight of panel having the largest area. In case of legal metrology rules, they consider one entire size of the rectangular shape container, but in case of FSSAI rule it is 40%, so there is some anomalies. This it is also rectification needed. In case of cylindrical or round or oval container, it is 20% of the product height and average circumference of the container. For any other container of any other shape, 20% of the total surface area, except in case where level is fixed, it shall cover at least 10% of total surface area of the container. So, these are the requirement of the principal display panel and requirement of the size of the level and declaration to be made on this area only. There is some restriction of declaration also, not to contain. This declaration cannot be given on the label or on the container, not to contain any reference of the act or rules or regulations, that this product is as per conforming to the FSSAI act or legal metrology act. It is not need not to be given. Not to use words implying recommendations by medical practitioner. One cannot write that this is recommended by a doctors or any medical practitioner. But however, certain cases like with the infant food, it is compulsory that should be written that the product should be taken with advice of the medical practitioner, but not in other cases. Unauthorized use of words showing imitation or substitute for any food. You cannot say this food is like that or superior to this product or imitation of certain product. The word pure or seems same significance cannot be declared on a product. You may have seen that many products they write it is a quality product or 100% pure. These are not allowed. And any other misleading statement or advertisement is also not allowed to be declared on the label. Like misleading, if it is a product is non-food product, a synthetic product, and you show a picture of the fruit, it is a misleading statement or advertisement. Or if a product you declare it is help, it is lower the weight or it is gain weight, if without any scientific evidence, these are the misleading statement. So, this is not to be permitted. With this I conclude my presentation with a caution to the food business operator that they should adhere to the labeling requirements of FSSAI regulations, and the consumers with a caution that whenever they buy any packaged food, they should see all the labeling declaration, whether it is best before is there or not, whether date of manufacture is not there, then they should buy the product.